Matt Barnes asks, helping parents make the transition from traditional to self-directed, how would you guide a parent along this path?
Yeah, I would say that the first step, I would say, is really and truly, I would say there are two or three things that you, that will help. One is read what has been written about it, read the experiences. But the second one is do what you can to get to know people who have already taken this path, other families who are doing this, who you can talk to and raise your questions with. You need to, one of the questions that I asked, I didn't ask this in the study of Sudbury Valley graduates, but one of the questions that we asked in our studies of unschoolers, people who are using self-directed education related to homeschooling, was what is the most difficult challenge of unschooling? And I think the same thing would apply for those who are sending their kids to a Sudbury school. And that far and away, they said the most difficult challenge is facing the criticism and implied criticism, and even maybe the imagined criticism that I'm getting from other people for doing this. That I have to explain over and over to my own parents why I'm doing this with their grandchildren. They think I'm ruining my grandchildren. I have to argue with my brothers and sisters, the kids' aunts and uncles. Even strangers will ask me why I'm doing this in an accusatory tone of voice. We have such an incredible, we are all ingrained as a society with the idea that if you don't do traditional school, you're going to be a failure in life. So even if you have personally become convinced based on the evidence and based on your own observations of your own child and how your child develops so well when under his, when the child can follow his or her own drives, you still, we're still all creatures of norms. We're all social creatures. And it is very, very difficult to buck such a strong social norm. Doing something that isn't isn't along what the norms are of society becomes in people's minds abnormal. And nobody wants to be abnormal. So what you have to do is develop a new normal by getting acquainted, becoming part of a community of other people already doing this. The more people who are doing this, the easier it becomes because you're no longer a lone pioneer doing this. You can talk with other people doing it. You can talk and you can also point out to people, look, by now there are thousands and thousands of people who are doing this and they're out there who have done this, who have grown up this way and they're out there doing well in the world. When Sudbury Valley started, nobody could say that. When the first people started unschooling back in, you know, when it became at all a trend around 1970, 71, 72, it was a matter of faith to a much greater degree than it is today. Today there's plenty of evidence that it works. Some people think of it, well, it's risky, but you know, everything in life is risky. And certainly sending your child to the public school is risky. Think of all the things that can happen in public school. Think of the, you know, there was a, we don't really have time to go into this, but just very briefly, there was a study by the American Psychological Association a few years ago on stress in America, in which they determined that teenagers in America are the most stressed out people in America. And and we know there are record levels of anxiety and depression as well among school age kids and teenagers in particular. 83% of those teenagers in that study said school was the primary source of their stress. So there are the rates of suicide among school age children are higher than they've ever been before, six times what they were in the 1950s when I was a kid in high school. The rate of suicide for school age kids is twice as high during months when school is in session than when it's not in session. So you're taking a risk sending your kid to school. Some people think the risk is school shooters, but compared to school shooters, suicide is a far bigger risk. There are huge numbers. Colleges are dealing with the fact that kids are coming in to college not prepared, without the maturity, without the social and emotional maturity required for independent living, because they haven't had enough experience with independent living. When you allow your child to be independent as they're growing, as they are, to the degree that is necessary for self-directed education, they learn how to take care of themselves. They learn how to be responsible, and they don't have mental breakdowns to the degree that kids have if they're going to school. So I think for anybody who thinks that it's risky to send your child to a school like Sudbury Valley or to do unschooling, think about the risk on the other side of the question.